Are you looking for lighting software for your church that's budget-friendly and easy to use without compromising on power and reliability? In this video, I'm gonna review LightKey, which is a Mac-based lighting software. I'll unpack all the reasons why I love this software and why I think it might just be the best lighting software for churches, and I'll also walk you through what you're gonna need to get this system set up at your church. Coming up. This video is brought to you by Worship Leader School, where you're gonna find all the essential training, advice, and support you need to plan and lead worship. Visit worshipleaderschool.com or click the link in the description to learn more. My name is Jake Goslin. I'm the creator of churchfront.com, helping you lead gospel-centered and tech-savvy worship. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel so you can receive all of our latest content to help you grow yourself and grow your worship ministry. Let's talk about lighting control for churches. A few years ago, it was more common to use an actual hardware controller to control the lights in your worship gathering. And I'm talking about stage lights as well as house lights, so you can fade lights up or down or create fancy light shows, whatever suits your fancy at your church. But today, the world of lighting control has evolved, and rather than needing an actual hardware controller, you can run software just on your computer. So at our church, we have a computer that runs ProPresenter, so why not put some lighting software on there as well that can control all the lighting? We're a portable church, and the less hardware for us, the better. In my opinion, lighting software for churches needs to meet certain criteria. Number one, it needs to be stable and reliable. We can't have the software glitch in the middle of a worship service and then have all the lighting scenes go haywire. The next piece of criteria is that the lighting software needs to be budget friendly. When I say budget friendly, I mean less than $1,000, ideally less than $500. I don't think software needs to be free, because that means there's no development and support actually going into it. And I'm not a big fan of open source software, because often it's confusing, just takes forever to figure out, and there's lots of weird glitches and bugs you have to deal with. So I'm willing to pay at least a couple hundred bucks if something is supported and it's reliable and it's just gonna work. Next, the lighting software needs to be user-friendly and intuitive. And I don't know what it is about lighting software. Over the past few years, as I've been searching for different pieces of software, they all seem really confusing. When you look at the software and the user interface, it just seems like you're staring at the cockpit of a jumbo jet or something like that. It's just really, really frustrating. And especially in our church context, when we have volunteers who aren't professionally trained, we need it to be just super intuitive for them. And we don't want them to have to go get a professional lighting degree to be able to run lights for our worship gathering. So being user-friendly is incredibly important. Another important thing lighting software needs to be able to do is it needs to have automation capability. At our church, we're small, we don't have a huge tech team, so we automate our lighting changes. And this is really cool when you use Ableton Live to send cues, so I can automate light changes throughout our songs, and we can create seamless transitions in the way that our light changes throughout the service. And finally, this is a more personal preference piece of criteria for lighting software, and that is it needs to be Mac-based software. And I know there's a lot of great PC-based software out there, but I prefer, for our context, we're running all Macs. It's just better to keep things all Macs all the time. And oftentimes there's lighting software out there that's developed for both Mac and PC. And then what I feel like happens is whenever companies try to develop for both platforms, one of them usually gets the short end of the stick. And the other reason it's important for us to have an all Mac ecosystem is for all the MIDI networking that we're doing. Mac has a really powerful, stable MIDI network app that makes it easy to connect any Macs to set up all this automation. So that's just another reason why it's so important for our software to be Mac based. But for those of you who are PC users, I'll link some other lighting software below that I think could be great in a PC environment. I just can't guarantee it's gonna give you great results. For the past couple of years, the lighting software I had been using was MyDMX 2.0 and then 3.0. This is a Mac and PC based software. It's easy to use, it's budget friendly, it has automation features. But recently, over the past couple months, it has been glitching on us like crazy. And the one main glitch that we continued to see time and time again is that when we were running the software on our Mac, the CPU usage we were seeing in our activity monitor was just skyrocketing. And I tried to do a ton of research to figure out how I could troubleshoot this problem. I think it had something to do with the MIDI automation. Anyways, I couldn't figure it out. If I can't figure something out after a couple hours of research, then it's pretty hopeless. And during our rehearsals and worship services, the computer running the software was starting to lag like crazy, and it was really frustrating for our volunteers and for myself. That's why I had to find a different solution. So I sat down at Google, I searched lighting software for Mac, and the first result I saw was the LightKey app. As I browsed their website, I was super impressed with what I saw. You can even download the software for free. I'll put a link in the description of this video. So I was able to like try it out and see what the user interface was like before even buying a license. And I was just super impressed. And I also went to the worship ministry Facebook groups and I searched the LightKey app in those groups and to see what type of experience people were having. And everything I read was positive. People loved it. So I was sold very quickly on this app. And then I told our pastor about it, he approved it. We purchased a license for the app. We purchased our USB to DMX dongle that's compatible with the app to be able to plug it into our lighting system, and we were up and running. So here's what you need to buy to get this system up and running. First, you need the LightKey software. I'm gonna link it in the description, and like I already said, you can download the software for free, but you'll have a very limited version of the software, but you'll be able to experience it enough to see whether or not you like this type of user interface. And then when you're ready, you need to buy a license for the software. They have different tier licenses, and the way it works is it's an annual subscription. So it starts at $69 for 256 channels of DMX. That actually may work for a lot of churches with smaller lighting systems. But the more standard favorite selection for a lot of people out there, this is the one we bought, is the 512 DMX channels subscription. So that's $99 per year. That may seem a little bit pricey. It's definitely not free, but in my opinion, it's worth it because you're investing into a software that's well supported and it's actually gonna be continually updated and made better over time. So once you purchase the license, you're gonna receive your license code. You just enter it into the software and it's ready to go. And the cool part is that that license code can be deactivated from a computer if you need to move it to another one. The next thing you're gonna have to purchase for this setup is a USB to DMX adapter. This makes it so that your computer can send the DMX signal to all of your lighting fixtures. At our church, we purchased the DMX King Ultra DMX Micro. It's a super compact little interface with USB on one side of the end and DMX on the other. And of course, for our MacBook Pro, because it's a newer one, I had to get the USB-C to USB adapter. The great part about this software is it's super efficient, doesn't suck up a bunch of CPU power or RAM, so you could run this lighting software on the same computer that maybe you have ProPresenter on. That's exactly how we're gonna run it at our church. So I'm gonna include links to the software and all my recommended hardware down below in the description of this video. Setting up the software itself is really simple and intuitive. The first step is to set up all your DMX patching. This is where you tell LightKey what light fixtures map to which DMX addresses. And the software already has a ton of lighting fixture profiles built into its library, so you can just search for whatever lighting fixtures you have at your church and then drag those on to the patch bay. When I set this patching up at my office, since our church is a setup and teardown church, I simply just copied the patching assignments that we had from my DMX 3.0, so it's really easy to get up and running. The next step is to edit the visualizer that's built into this software. This is a great feature that allows you to see your light scenes and make edits and design your lighting cues at home when you're not plugged into the lighting system at church. It took me just a couple minutes to add in these trusses and this rectangle to symbolize our widescreen that we project our lyrics and video on. But now, when I'm in my office, because we're a setup and teardown church, I can design all of our lighting cues and know exactly what it's gonna look like when Sunday comes. The next step is to start building your presets or lighting scenes. And you click the little plus icon on the top right of the software. And I went through and I created lighting scenes for our house lights, our stage spotlights, our different LED kind of backlighting color combos that we have. Also, we have some truss warmers, the lights that shoot straight up through the trusses. Made some scenes for those. And then I also made some scenes that include some movement, and I even added some of the crazy scenes that they have built into the software. Then once you're done building out all of your presets, you're gonna create your control panel. And this is the interface that you or your lighting volunteers or your tech team are actually gonna use to control the lights during the service. What's really cool about this control panel is that it gives you the ability to create buttons and faders, and it's all virtual. And then you can assign whatever presets you want to those buttons or faders. So it's a little bit hard to describe, and it's something that you're just gonna wanna play with yourself, but let me show you how I have the queue set up for our church. So on the far left, we have the master fader. That just brings all the lights up or down. We don't really ever touch that one. And then we have a collection of house lighting queues. So we have our house black, blackout queue, our house full queue, our house pre-service queue, worship queue, and message queue. Next to that, we have a collection of spotlight cues. And this is just our front lighting on stage that control two ellipsoidal lights that light both the band members and our pastor. We don't have many scenes for this, really just our band settings, our speaker settings, and a blackout. The next bank of cues is a fun one. This is where we control all of our LED lighting that we have. So we have 8 LED wash lights that are mounted kind of on the top of the trusses. And then we have 4 of them that are truss warmers shooting light up through the trusses. So I went through and I created all these different buttons that you simply click on, and that'll cue up the appropriate LED lights. And the way I have all my LED light cues set up in this software is that only one of those cues is gonna be enabled at a time. So this prevents any weird overlapping of colors, and it just makes it really, really simple for operation, whether we're operating it manually from the computer or if I'm cueing these scenes from Ableton Live. And then on the far right, we have 2 little faders that control the fan and the amount of haze for our haze machine. What's cool about the different groups of lighting cues that we've created in this control panel is that they can be layered on top of one another. So that means our house lights and then our front lighting and our LED backlighting, they can all be controlled independently. So we don't have scenes that necessarily control all of them at once. Instead, we send separate cues to our LED lights or separate cues to our front lighting or separate cues to our house lighting. And this workflow works really well for the way that we cue lights throughout our worship gathering. Then the final step in my setup process with this lighting software is automation. And they've made it incredibly easy to set up lighting automation if you're using software like Ableton Live to cue your lights and lyrics and other production and elements in worship. Setting this up is really easy. First, all you have to do is make sure light key is receiving MIDI cues from the network session that you're sending MIDI cues to from your Ableton Live computer. And then when that MIDI mapping is set up, you go to the different cues you've created in the control panel, you right click on a cue, you go down to external control, and then you just simply click the add trigger button. The software will then start listening for a MIDI trigger, and as soon as you send over that MIDI note, it's gonna map it. There's so much more that light key can do that I don't have time to cover in this video, but I hope this gives you a really full understanding and a great look at what it could do for your worship ministry. If you have any questions about this setup, let me know below in the comments, and also head on over to the website. I'll put a link in the description of this video where you can download the software for free and try it out yourself. And then if you do pull the trigger on the license, you can get the USB dongle from Amazon. I'll link that below as well. I really think you're gonna enjoy this software for your worship ministry, and I will let you know if anything changes with it. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. But so far, my experience with this is awesome. I highly recommend it. This gets Jake's stamp of approval. To learn more about implementing the latest technology for your worship ministry, check out Worship Leader School, where you're gonna find in-depth, step-by-step courses to walk you through all of this stuff that I showed you here, including this software, as well as how to use Ableton Live in worship. Visit worshipleaderschool.com or click the link in the description to learn more. Thanks so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, hit that thumbs up button and share it with your friends in ministry. You can find some related videos right over here, and don't forget to subscribe to the Church Front channel so you can receive all of our latest content to help you grow yourself and grow your church.